Hello everybody, this is Heiko from Tokyo MGG, and I'm here with popular pro player Tomoharu Saito from Japan.
Hi.
And we're doing a deck tech today with him. This is Friday right now, but this deck tech will only go up on YouTube after Monday, because he has some very interesting things that he did with his deck for this event in particular. Well, thank you very much for coming here. And Mr. Saito will be talking to us in Japanese, so that Japanese players can also follow our conversation, and I will be translating to English for all of you. So maybe we shall start, first of all, when did you start using this deck? And can you tell us about why you started using this deck?
2-3 週間前にこのデッキ使い出して、その理由は、このラストブレスが、入った青白が強いなってひらめいたんですけど、すでにポピュラーだったんですけどね、その時は。
はい。So first of all, he started using this deck 2 or 3 weeks ago, and he was thinking maybe this is a card, Last Breath, that can be used properly in this kind of deck. And as it turned out, he was not the only person thinking that. Others were also thinking the same thing. So it turned out that it might be a good choice for him. And can you tell us a bit, like how you tested this deck? Maybe who you tested it with?
特に誰かとっていうのはそんなにやってなくて、自分のトーナメントセンターとか、あと MO でやりました。
He mostly tested on Magic Online, and also not with anybody in particular, but generally just at his store, which is a big tournament store where there's tournaments every day, and where he played a lot himself, so he had a lot of chance to test. Okay, so...
ちょっとずつやったんですけど。
はい。
こんな感じで。全部スコアつけてていっぱいやりました。
So this is he put notes on when he was winning and how he was winning, and this is how he prepared for the event. Very nice. Okay, so let's talk about the different card choices maybe. So first of all, can you tell us a bit about the mana base?
普通の青白コントロールと、同じようなカードラインナップなんですけど、一応変わり谷が4枚っていうのと、あと白マナが少なめになってます。
So what's interesting to see here is that is two points. First of all, the white mana is less than normal, and there are 4 mutables in this blue-white control deck. And can you tell us what is up with that? Why did you choose to make your mana base like this?
結構変わり谷2枚っていうのが見たリストで多かったんですけど、やっぱりその特に対コントロールとか、対変わり谷とかみんな変わり谷使ってるんですけど、で強いんでこれは4使いたいっていうのがそもそもあって、で白マナは
So first of all, maybe let me translate. Usually this card is only a 1 or 2 of in many control lists, but Mr. Saito thought that this card is just so strong he definitely wants to play for it, because it's also good in many matchups, especially in the control matchups. And now, does that lead to any problems with your white spells, that you have less planes, or is there no problem with that?
皆さんはサイドボードに白々のカード、M14 のナイトとか結構取られてて、それだと確かに困るんですけど、なんかこの環境青白でラストブレス4、アドリウスチャーム4、スフィア4ってあると、これが4ターン目じゃなくてもいいんで、これだけ白これだけにして、代わり台に使った方がいいかなって
結論。 So what Mr. Saito realized in his testing wasThat in reality there is not all that much white that you need in the main deck, and instead of using, for example, sideboard slots for the M14 knight that also costs double white, he tried to make sure to use as little white as possible in his deck. And so the Azorius Charm is only one white, the Detention Sphere is only one white, and really the only thingThat you need two white mana for is the 4 mana Wrath of God Supreme Verdict, which can also be a bit later in the game, and it won't be a problem. So, can you tell us a bit more about your sideboard in general?
その白を少なくできた理由でもあるんですけど、最初は楽しくてやってたんですけど、 このまあフロストバーンと、マスターオブウェーブをサイド5入れてモノブルーデボーションにこうトランスフォーム変身できるような感じで試してて、まあ、そもそもそのさっき言ってた M14 ナイトって赤対策で、まあ、これも赤対策でその入れ替え候補としてまず試してそれが強かったのでそのまま来ました。
Thank you. So here's an interesting point about his deck, which is the transformational sideboard. He was thinking that if you think about why the Fiendslayer Paladin, which costs double white, is in use, it's mostly because it's good against red. And Master of Waves and Frostbone Wood turning this into a blue deck after the sideboard also is very good against red, so he thought this would make the main deck much more smoother and the mana base smoother, so there's more blue and there's less issues when using the mana ward.
あと、これがそのナイトよりも受けが広くて、ホワイトウィニーとか、あと青白コントロール、エスパーコントロール系にも結構強くて、でやっぱりメインが、青白クリーチャーないデッキでサイド5クリーチャーっていうのがその昔ながらですけど結構強くて。
Right, so what he's saying in addition is that not only is this transformational sideboard good against red, it's good in many matchups in general, and it's pretty much an old school thought idea that this is fairly enjoyable to turn a non-creature deck in the main deck into a creature deck in the sideboard, and so that's what he's been trying to do with his deck.
青タンとしては中途半端なんですけど、青タンとしては中途半端なんですけど、そのメインクリーチャー入ってないデッキから出すっていうその攻撃力としてはもう十分な感じでした。
So, I mean, actually, if he transforms into a mono blue deck with this sideboard, it's not all that strong as a mono blue deck.But as it turns out, if all of a sudden there's many creatures coming out of a typical non-creature deck, then that's something that's generally very strong in his opinion.
あとは実際に2週間前のグランプリアンテワープで、青白デボーションっていうのがあったんですよね。これもう青白コントロールと青タンデボーションのもうハイブリッドみたいなデッキがトップ16に入ってて、そういうデッキが結果残すっていうことは、まあこれ青ターンとしては物足りないけど、やっぱり青白のアゾリウスの強いカードがやっぱりもう本当にみんな知ってる通り強いカードが使える色なんで。
Yes, so one more point that he thought is that、two weeks ago at the Grand Prix Antwerp in Europe, there was a deck in the top 16 that he discovered that also was a hybrid between blue-white and the mono-blue、devotion deck.And because of that, it gave him confidence that basically just using all these strong cards together is what is going to make this deck strong, and it can't go wrong. And this is his tech for the tournament.、what about、the last cards?
すみません、アンテワープじゃないや。ダラス・フォートワースでした。GP、
okay.
ダラス。
Sorry, it was GP Dallas, not Antwerp. What about the last cards in your sideboard?
どうですか？
はい。
これはノートスペシャル。
This is not special at all. This is just a typical sideboard. 強いカードで、ま
あ、結構一番負けるのが黒系だったんで、こうこれチェス4枚入ってるんですけど、その上から5枚目、6枚目って、まあ、これ黒に強いんで、2枚入ってるのはちょっと黒を意識してる。
So by adding the two Jaces in the sideboard in addition, he was making sure that he has something to do against the mono black deck, which he thinks these are strong against. So, Mr. Saito, what do you expect for the main event? What kind of decks do you expect to see as your opponents? Like strong Japanese players, what decks will they use?
青白コントロールが今回多そうです。
Okay, and he's saying that because this control deck is going to be、there's going to be a lot of people using this deck, he thinks that this is going to be a good choice, especially with the transformational sideboard. Anything else you want to add? もう大丈夫ですか？
あ、終わりですか？
はい、
大丈夫です。
OK, so this is all from Tomoharu Saito.
あれですね、これブルーホワイトコントロール、青白コントロール、すごい時間かかるじゃないですか、よく、はい、で、これ時間対策としてもいいですよね、この辺。
あ、なるほどですね。 Yeah, and one reason that he's also using the cards in the sideboard is that because this deck always takes a lot of time, And so this is one way to not use as much time with this thing.
This one very quick.
It's a very quick creature and so it's very good for me. Alright, thank you very much.
はい、ありがとうございます。
For this interview, arigatouございました.
ありがとうございます。
And I wish you best of luck. Like, after this video